again, Showtime is back in Loughborough. Time to welcome the teams to the floor, starting with the listed away team. Let's get a round of applause for Charnwood College Riders. And their roster for today, running number 4, Jacob Adams. Running number 6, Louis Jordan. Running number 7, Nathan Conaty. Running number 8, and captain Greg Wild. Running number 9, Matt Keegan. Running number 10, CJ Hanson. Running number 11, Simeon Perry. Running number 14, Mojo Bradwell. Running number 22, Kai Bradburn Lewis. In number 23, Victor Ndugu. Running number 24, Paulo Gutter. And in at number 25, Giovanni Ndugu. Their head coach is Will Haynard, assisted by Mason Aslan. Ladies and gentlemen, round of applause for the home team, the Loughborough Student Riders. And their roster for today, running number 4, Joe Bielak. In at number 5, Connor O'Reilly.
Hello, good afternoon and welcome to Loughborough University. We've got Lynch Trophy action coming up for you in 5.5 minutes' time as the local Loughborough Derby, the Loughborough Riders taking on the Charnwood Riders.
Number 12, it's Harrison Gamble. Number 13, Jonas Dietrich. Number 20, Lynn Johnson. Number 21, Justin Henley. Number 25, Noah Aleke. And their head coach is Roger, assisted by Liam Jackson.
Good afternoon and welcome to Loughborough University, where we have the Loughborough Derby here, the two riders teams in the Lynch Trophy going head to head as the Loughborough Riders take on Charnwood College. Dan Ratledge and Ampro with you for today's game, and these two teams, Ampro, know each other very well, and I'm sure there'll be plenty of pride on the line here for this game.
Yeah, this is like a family game with the little brother trying to get a quick win against the big brother. A lot of these players would have, well, especially the pathways, a lot of these Loughborough guys would have played in the Charnwood Academy setup and know exactly what they'd be feeling like in their shoes today. So, yeah, you want to see a little bit of a rivalry and perhaps, a grudge match for years to come.
Well, the Lynch Trophy already well underway. One group, in fact, completed. This group was obviously delayed because of the coronavirus. They'll be glad just to get out there on floor and be playing some basketball in a meaningful competition.
I think that's on the mind of a lot of basketball players in this country and across the world as well. You know, practice can be pretty intense at the best of times, but I think not having that forward-looking date to look forward to can be very, very difficult for a lot of these programs to account for. But here we are, you know, live basketball and a chance for these two teams to go up against each other.
Well, you described it as younger brother against older brother. Loughborough will be big favourites coming into this game. Charnwood, really, it's almost a free hit for them, if you like, but they've got to come out here and feel that they're able to take on the big brother.
For sure, and you know, it can go either two ways. You know, it can be that blowout where the psychology of the older, you know, bigger, stronger team just prevails, or you can have that fearless little brother that one Saturday afternoon could find up the courage to muster a win.
And from the Loughborough side of the ball, obviously their season slightly delayed, but they'll want to get and use this competition as a way of building up into the league season.
Pre-season tournaments games have never ever been more crucial than a situation we're in now. You know, typically you'd have your, you know, 5, 6, 7 warm-up games before the season tips off. This is you know, it's unexperienced circumstances, just as we're living outside and off the court. So, you know, these games are even much more, you know, important to tune in, the team to play together in a real game situation.
Well, this is group 3 of the Lynch Trophy. There's only been one game played so far. That was the Leicester Warriors, beaten 88-92 by the Nottingham Hoods. But the remainder of this group scheduled for the next 2 weeks, 3 of the games here and 3 of them at Charnwood, as they try and catch up with the other groups who are all much closer to finishing. Solent's group and almost finished, just one game left to play. They had finished group 2 with Thames Valley and Hemel through. They were only separated really by one shot in the meeting between them, and they've still got a couple of games to play in group 4 as well. But obviously the league season underway this weekend as well, as they're trying to catch up on these games, and I'm sure it'll be a challenge all the way through the season, just getting used to the fact that games will be postponed, will be rearranged. It will be a challenge for teams, and some of that is about the mental strength that the teams will have to get through the challenges on and off the court.
Yeah, incredibly difficult. I think, you know, typically you're looking to get yourself in physical shape and then, you know, mentally adapt to the team. But, you know, these circumstances, as you described, Dan, there's a whole lot of other factors here, you know, contributing to mentally being ready for the start of the season.
The two teams out and ready to go for the opening tip for the first game of the season for these sides. And as we've seen across sports, two teams take the knee. And we are ready to get things underway with the opening tip. And it's Loughborough who will get the first possession of the game. As the nominal home team is Gamble in the low post. Moves it out. Well, 3-point shot off the mark from Jimenez.
Good patient start though from Loughborough. Got the ball inside to their experienced vet, and they got a good 3-point shot there.
And it'll be interesting to see how they start out, John, but I think much of this game will be played in the first quarter as to how well they will be able to compete. The first shot of the game rings out from Nduku. You'd expect Loughborough to look to go in size with some of the size and bulk advantage that they have, but it's well defended here, late in the shot clock. And the first points of the game on the board for Headley.
Big shot from Headley there, but really good defense. Good intensity there, good switching.
The 1 foot off balance shot from Wild.
That's the inexperience thinking through there. A little bit too excited.
Good stand at the other end as the offensive foul called on Headley. Just ran his man down, even though he passed the ball off.
Good, putting his body on the line there, giving his team back possession, so another opportunity to get a score on the board here.
with full court pressure from Loughborough here, just to delay the game as much as anything else. Wild. High pick and roll, a little hesitation, but the pass thrown away. And there's going to be a foul there. Under reach, Jordan, the offender. Well, what they wouldn't want it to do, Charnwood, is take too long to get that first point on the board, even though they haven't scored in the opening 2 minutes. They're only two down.
The longer it takes, we all know that, yeah, the bigger a deal it is.
It's Gamble. Inside to Hayden, trying to use his size and doing so effectively to double up the lead.
Well, they went inside early to Hayden and Gamble, and they've got good looks from it, and that time Hayden powering his way through for an easy two.
He's around the screen. Hands it off to Jordan. Looking to attack, driving hard. A little too strong on that. Looking to push the other way with Dietrich. Stolen away, ball loose on the floor. Still a bit of a scramble. Goodzer eventually comes up with it. Wildfire's up for three, and there are the first points for Charnwood.
Great work there from Goodzer. He had the possession, lost possession, had possession, and a good look across court there and knocked down three.
Once again, going down to the low block. Same shot, different result this time for Hayden.
Hayden trying to get to that strong right hand there. Unsuccessful on this attempt.
There's another three-point shot, that one off the back of the ring. I think it might have touched the string. Referee says it's okay. Enough for play transition here. Dietrich with the catch and shoot. Rims out.
Both teams taking some quick shots early in the offensive possession. You don't know if that's a style of play or if it's because they're excited to be on court again, but it's either an early shot or a turnover from both teams at the moment.
Yeah, I don't think either coach will be too pleased with how the team's taking care of the ball, but good work from Hayden on the offensive glass. And once he gets that close, you're not going to stop him.
And that's the struggle that Charnwood are going to see, that brute strength and physicality down low and the desire to want to come up with those rebounds. Typically favoured in the more experienced, stronger players.
Again, late in the shot clock here. Drew has to do something quick, gets it away in time, but nothing doing. Gamble bringing it the other way. Again, it goes down low to Headley. Looking to use his size and strength, but that's an offensive foul. Sometimes the bigs get a little excited when they have they feel a mismatch on their back, and he's just a little too aggressive for the referee's liking.
A tough call. It's typically a lot of contact down there anyway, but defender did a good job of not letting him get to that right hand.
Perry into the game for the first time for Charnwood. Again, an open shot, and again it's good for Greg Wild. His second three of the game, ties it up at six.
Greg Wild looking for a shot early. He's been aggressive, and two threes for him now.
Jimenez, cross court, open shot in the corner, a little bit short. A little hesitation, trying to find a shot in the lane, and that's going to be a traveling violation. Didn't quite get the ball down in time there, Perry.
A good cut from Perry as well, well timed. Hand off from Wild, but just, yeah, as you said, Dan, just couldn't quite get that ball down fast enough.
Gamble throwing it inside once again. Headley for his second bucket of the game.
Good looking shot as well, curled off that top of the key, and nice mid range finish from him.
8-6 here, just past the midpoint of the first quarter in a game tied up from Gudza.
Really positive start from Gudza as well. Both ends of the floor on that occasion. Great take. Showed aggression and intent to get to the rim.
And as along the baseline, trying to hook one inside. A slightly fortunate deflection, and it ends in the hands of Headley again. And Loughborough back in front.
Well, you can tell Headley's in touch offensively at the moment. In right place, right time, and nice stop finish from him.
Pass deflected away as it was intended for Wild. It'll stay with Charnwood. Inline ball for Charnwood. 15 on the shot clock. Nice cut to the basket, but unable to finish. Ndoko. Gamble has the height mismatch here, spinning along the baseline, trying to feed the pass along to Jimenez, but turned over. Gives up. Little hesitation, gets to the elbow, pulls up off the mark. Good rebound from Dietrich. Off the quick down court, foul called on the inside. Antifo taking the contact.
Antifo just did really well there running the floor. He was the first man down there, got good positioning under the rim. It was either going to be a basket or a foul. Good running from the big man. Good early signs though for Charnwood, and you know, Gudza looks aggressive there, going to the rim, and Wilder as well has been aggressive and looking for a shot.
Second one a long way short. 3 point Loughborough lead. 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter. First quarter kick. 3 point shot doesn't go, but an offensive rebound is put back in. Imadura, and almost another opportunity there. Gamble's able to clean it up. Jimenez penetrates, kicks out. Nice pass. Doesn't get the assist though, as Dietrich's three rims out.
It's all rim too. Could have very easily dropped.
A little early in the offense there for Charnwood. Loughborough coming back the other way. Tough shot from almost behind the backboard.
Very good defense.
Dietrich kept it alive. Stumbling out of control, and it's going to be a travelling violation against Perry.
Perry was just trying to make something happen there, but Harrison Gamble beat him to the spot, and ultimately he lost control. But Charnwood looking to attack the rim as well as a couple of knockdown threes from Wild, which is encouraging when you've got shooters on the perimeter.
Well, Jimenez looks like he's hobbling a little bit here, but he's not coming out of the game. Doesn't quite seem to be moving as freely as he was earlier. He gets the handoff from Gamble, penetrates through, and he's still able to find a good pass, and Tifo with the jam.
Wow, perfect example there of penetration and dump down for the big man. Jimenez, excellent way to get in the heart of the defense there and dump down for his big for the dunk.
He's definitely done something. He's hobbled off to the bench for this timeout. Just under 2 minutes to go here at Loughborough University. It's 13 points to 10. One of the good things about being here in Loughborough is they remind you of the greats who've gone before you. hanging from the wall across the way there.
Yeah, we've had some good times wearing the purple, Dan. It's been a very, very good partnership, I think. You know, is an understatement between the riders, Loughborough and Charnwood. It's been it's the blueprint, you know, that you'd want every UK basketball program to have, that natural filter and progression there. And even if the high school kids or the secondary school kids want to go to America, we've got examples here of them wanting to go over to America. For whatever reason, it hasn't worked out, then they can even come back to a program, you know, as established such as Loughborough University. So, yeah, fantastic, you know, filter system here.
Well, that is a notable. A number of the Loughborough players have been for a season to junior college or even full college, if you like, and have come back because it hasn't worked out for them for any whatever reason it is. And that's the thing I would say that's been the development of the game in the last 10, 15 years. We see places up and down the country where programs are linked to universities and to college programs, as with Charnwood, and giving kids an opportunity, if they don't want to go to the States or it doesn't work out for them, to still get a college and university education in this country. Charnwood will keep possession of the ball with 10 seconds on the shot clock.
I think it's a partnership as well that, you know, that the BBL teams need these university teams just as much as the university teams need the BBL teams. It's a perfect partnership that benefits both ends.
3-point shot off the mark from Rubber and Lewis, and Loughborough come away with it. Gamble. Dietrich down to Gamble in the low post. Spinning to the hook. And he's an experienced player, Harrison Gamble. Known at the BBL level as a 3-point shooter, but with his size, he's certainly more comfortable down in the low post.
He's one of those players too that throughout his whole career he's been anywhere from a 3 to a 5, you know, so he's got that versatility down low as well. And yeah, yes, the experience, but also he's 6'10". You know, it's a difficult matchup for anyone down low.
Loughborough here with a chance to open their biggest lead of the game, just starting to get a little bit of momentum at the end of the first quarter, and they'll get two more free throws.
It's good to see Jimenez back on the floor, and you know, typically when you're injured you'll shy away to the quarter three ball, but he's still being very aggressive and attacking the rim, which is encouraging to see.
I must admit, the way he hobbled into the timeout, I assumed he wasn't going to come back out from that timeout, but he's back out there, misses both free throws, but Dietrich gets it back for Loughborough, and Charm would dodge a bullet there.
They do. Good work from there, Dietrich there.
There's Wild looking to attack in, throws it back. I'm not sure whether it was an intended pass or not, but it managed to get to Amajuru, who's turned it into a couple of free throws.
I like Amajuru's activity as well. A really difficult start for him in this game. He's been matched up against the bigger and stronger opposition there. But since the turning, I'd say that the 3 or 4 minute mark, he's been very aggressive, especially on the offensive rebound and playing tough defense. Good start from him. He's someone that's currently piquing interest from the Division I schools in America at the moment. And, you know, as a retired basketball player, you often look at those guys with jealousy.
Yeah.
The world is their oyster.
Yeah.
He's got a good basketball body, seems to move pretty well.
It is Wild. Only 14 on the reset, so they need to go quick here. Here's Amajuru. Get to the hole and good finish as well.
Beautiful move. Shot clock winding down. Caught the ball at the top of the 3-point line. Found a way to get all the way to the rim for the two.
We're ticking it down for the final shot here of the opening quarter. And it scooped away. What a finish. Right on the buzzer. Well, with the finger, I'll just toss it up. And it's a 4-point Loughborough lead at the end of the opening quarter.
Wow, morale with a Steve Nash-esque shot to finish the first quarter there, and wow, 4-point game, that pretty close close encounter.
I think Charnwood would be pretty pleased, because I mean, we were talking first 3 minutes or so they hadn't scored. It looked like it was going to be hard for them to get points on the board, but once that first couple of shots went in from Wild, they sort of grew into the game, felt a lot more comfortable in themselves.
Yeah, they showed a little maturity early on. In the first few minutes, like you said, they found it very, very difficult. And that's, you know, if you look at a lot of blowouts, you know, a lot of them start in the earlier stages because the team just hasn't been able to settle into the game. And before they know it, the bigger, stronger, more dominant team have just taken full advantage of that. But they've done a really good job. I think Wild was the guy, you know, he knew that he was fancying his shot early and looked aggressively for that 3-point shot. But then, you know, he was supported by some cast there that are, you know, in Goodza, and that was attacking the rim and trying to make things happen there, you know, with a more of a high percentage perspective on the offensive options.
And Emajura, we talked about his offense there with the 5 points laid on, but six rebounds in the first quarter, three at either end, really doing a good job on the glass for them.
Fantastic start, yeah, great. He looked active, but 6 points already, wow.
And he's got half the rebounds for his team. But you just felt in the last couple of minutes like Loughborough had gained a little bit of momentum. It hasn't quite reflected into the scoreboard as they might like, but I'm sure they'll be looking to stretch that lead here in this second quarter. Because the other thing about it is, because they've got this delayed start to the season, they will have games coming thick and fast from now on. But, they obviously play on Tuesday against Nottingham in the Lynch Trophy. Wild trying to get free to get the ball. Oh, foul called in the basket is good. And that will be a bonus shot there for Nduku.
Good play from Nduku. I mean, he's caught the ball at the top of the three-point line with very little options. Isolation play, essentially. Nice little spin, kept control, didn't travel, then was able to pull up, you know, power through there to convert in the hope of a three-point play here.
And it did look at first as if the only option was to travel when he got kind of stuck there, but he managed to power through, and he's cut it down to 2 points here. Dietrich at the high post, kicks it back out. What a 1-3-1 zone by the looks of it here from Charnwood. Ball batted away, it certainly threw Loughborough off for a second. He's going hard to the hole, and again, takes the contact. And once more, he'll go to the free throw line.
Good defensive possession there from Charnwood College. They were out to the races, had the numbers, but Nduku kept hold of that ball and took it all the way himself.
Coach Maynard throwing the 1-3-1 out there. Don't see that very often. Do you ever play a 1-3-1 zone?
No, not a lot, no.
First free throw is good, and now the chance to level the game at 17. There's precisely that. Harrison Gamble is going to return to the action for Loughborough. Tifo sitting down. Dietrich has space, top of the key. Dangerous man to leave open. Doesn't make them pay, though.
Another good rebound.
Space for Wild. Another dangerous guy to leave open. That's his third of the game.
Wild is there. No conscience whatsoever. Give him half an inch, and he's putting it up.
Dietrich penetrating. Has the ball knocked away. Charnwood with the lead and the possession here. Another three-point shot goes up, this time short. Loughborough a chance to cut the gap here. Good defense on the far side. They've lost Dietrich in the corner and he ties the game up at 20.
Good basketball there from Loughborough. Under a little bit of pressure there defensively from Charnwood. They were patient, swung the basketball, and good knockdown from Dietrich.
Wow, penetrates the basket. Took a little bit of contact, but was still able to score.
Wild says this three-point shooting's too easy for me. I'm taking it inside.
His gamble, top of the key for three, just off the mark. No way through for Jordan. Majuru lets fly from three-point range. And without him in on the glass, it's an easy rebound for Gamble. There's a little push in the back there on the rebound. Foul called on Hayden.
Chumwa did get away with one there because Henley had a wide open three, had plenty of time. He kind of rushed into it as he stepped into it, but he had time to gather himself for that split second longer.
Charnwood up by two, and Duke are trying to stretch that. It's tipped away and will be a Loughborough ball. All on his own in the corner. Can't get that one to go either. Wild with the defensive rebound.
Oh, Dietrich won't miss too many of those.
And again, another three. Jordan this time getting in on the three-pointer. Head shot. Here he is again. Finally gets one to go. Good court as well. And Jonas will go to the line for a four-point play.
Well, you got to remember, Dietrich's played at every level, third team, second team, first team, and then the pro team with the Leicester Riders, so he's an extremely experienced player, and a very good player at that. Can't leave him open too many times because he will punish you, and here he is on the line, a potential four-point play.
Well, they gave him a few sighters. They were all down in that corner. He was going to make one eventually, and he turns it into a four-point play. Jordan brings it across half court. Space to attack, picked out Nduku in the corner. And that will not be kept in by Charnwood and will be possession for Loughborough. 6:26 to go here in the first half. It's a one-point ball game in favour of Charnwood.
My concern, if I was Will Maynard, no. At the last, you know, several possessions, the shots have been deep twos or three-point shots. Yes, there's been occasions where they've dropped, but you know, you've got control of the game here. Don't stop attacking the rim and making things happen.
Well, nice steal and easy lay in transition for Lewis.
Brandon Lewis picks the pocket and open floor for him for the easy lay-in.
Gamble putting it on the floor. We've had a lot of three-point attempts in this corner. They've not been very effective from it. Loughborough 2 of 12 now from the three-point line. Oh, nice. Wild to the basket. And he lays it in for two. Well, Jaron's seen enough of that. He's going to have to call a timeout. This Loughborough side trailed by five here as we approach the midpoint of this second quarter. And Charnwood really have the bit between their teeth right now.
Well, they've just injected mass amounts of energy into this game. And you can see as the longer this game goes on for, the fear factor is not existent. They're playing like a team that legitimately believes they should be here and they've got a chance to win this ball game. But no, fantastic courage from some of the younger players here.
Well, they've been able to get transition points off turnovers in double figures already. 10, when you only got 29 on the board, 10 off turnovers is a good output. They've got 5 second chance points as well, 7 on the break. They've found different ways of scoring, but a lot of it through energy.
And I think Mark Jerome will be upset with the turnovers that Loughborough are causing. The turnovers that Loughborough are committing, and especially at the top there, you turn the ball over, and with someone there like Lewis in the vicinity, and it's almost a guaranteed bucket, in which it was on that occasion. So Loughborough got to look after the ball a bit better. I think defensively, Charnwood would have been very good. I think they from the first minute, their energy's been there, their intent's been there. I think the rotations have improved as this game's went on.
8 turnovers.
Wow.
For Loughborough in, less than 15 minutes here.
Yeah, Coach Jerome won't be happy with those figures. And I think the manner in which some of the turnovers have been committed is not going to be acceptable to his standards.
Back underway here. Loughborough trailing by 5. Looking to do something about it. Gamble, space for 3. 3-point shot has not been dropping for Loughborough so far this afternoon. Oh, breakdown defensively. An easy jam for Simeon Perry.
Wow, great work there from Goodza. And Perry with a throwdown.
Gamble wants it down in the low post. Double team comes, so he kicks it cross court. Good recognition, almost a 3-point play opportunity, but it will be 2 free throws after the foul on Vila. But good recognition from Gamble. He wanted the ball because he had a mismatch, a double team very quick to him, and he found the open teammate on the opposite side of the floor.
Well, that's one of Gamble's qualities, his vision and basketball IQ. And Bilak as well complimented his teammate there and didn't jack up that 3-point shot. Loughborough clearly struggling from the 3 at the moment, and Bilak knew that he needed to get something a little bit closer to the rim and finds himself on the free throw line.
But cannot convert, although an offensive rebound by Dumanez. Down 7, no foul on the play. Everybody looking for a whistle, but Charnwood away, and Bradburn Lewis with another streaking layup, and Charnwood lead by 9 here.
Wow.
Dietrich in the corner, airballs it. I wonder if Coach Jarrell might think of another timeout here, because everything going against his team. That was a slightly dangerous pass, but it made it to Wild. And not so much on the second one there from Bradburn Lewis. And that's one where perhaps they just needed to slow it down and run something a bit more patient and try and get that double figure lead. Once again, it's down to Gamble in the low block. The double team comes, but this time he keeps it alone. Gamble with the hook is fouled, and Harrison Gamble will go to line for 2.
Well, even when Harrison catches the ball down low, he's under immense pressure from that Charnwood interior defense.
Well, they sort of threw a couple of double teams at him. Different players at different moments, diving down at the ball to make it difficult for him.
That's all you want to do, I think. If in Charnwood's position, you want to stay locked in mentally, make things extremely, you know, as extremely difficult as you possibly can for this Loughborough offense.
Oh, that's unfortunate. He struggled a bit from the line as well, Loughborough, today. But they get a fortunate break on the rebound to get the ball back.
Be interesting to see as well statistically how that is across other leagues as well. I mean, the shot, you know, the free throw, you know, the 3-point shot. But these are things you can't do in your house. You know, it's things we practice these hundreds of repetitions every day, and you take that out of the equation. It'll be really interesting to see how that leaks into the actual in-game play.
Thank you. just some confusion over who was coming in and who wasn't. It's good, so he's going to sit down.
Unfortunate that knocked out. You could tell what he was trying to do. He was already running the floor before he caught the basketball and misjudged it, and out of bounds it goes.
Down towards Gamble, and Majuru a little too aggressive over the back. He's called for the foul. Fourth team foul on Charnwood. Once again, they've had that corner three all game. Only one of them has gone in. But they've been given plenty of opportunities to knock it down. I suppose, to carry on your point about you can't do that in your back garden, if you did have a garden with a big enough thing, it tends to be straight away. It doesn't, you're not going to have a corner three to be shooting. And they certainly need some work on that, judging by today's evidence, Loughborough. Here's Wild for Charnwood, who lead this one by eight as we approach half time. Knew what he wanted to do and then realized it wasn't the right thing to do because the Majuru had left his feet. It's a travelling violation.
Yeah, it's the it's that sin. Don't leave your feet until you know what to do. Quarter three was
there it is. Well, I just keep letting them take it the way it's going. Other than the one that turned into a four-point play, they missed them all. Nice. Once again from Njuku in the paint. And it's a double-figure Charnwood lead.
Njuku really aggressive getting to that rim. And as soon as he's around the rim, he's got really good body control and soft touch. Very useful in there.
Inside to Gamble. Well defended, but another offensive rebound blocked there, and Charnwood come away with it. Wild throwing it the length of the court, just a little too far out in front of Njuku, and it will be a Loughborough ball, but concerning for them at the other end of the floor. Harrison Gamble down on the floor, looks like he's injured himself. He's going to come out, replaced by Hayden. I didn't see exactly what he did, but he's, whether he got a poke in the eye or something, he seems to be.
Yeah, I think it looks that way. There was a lot of bodies in there. We're a little bit further away from the court as usual,
so it's hard
to see.
We're out on the boundary in cricketing parlance. Jimenez driving in, a little change of pace, and again, Hayden on the offensive rebound, and they've got another second chance opportunity. They have had six offensive rebounds so far. They've only managed 2 points from those. The Majuru will check back in.
Loughborough want to get Hayden back involved as well. He's someone that started the first quarter, you know, active. They went to him early and since hasn't really had much involvement offensively.
Oh, look at first, so that was going to be the key for them, just pounded inside. But they spent a lot of time on the three-point line in this first half. 16 threes and only 14 twos. And that's never a good thing when you're shooting 12% from the three-point line.
No, it is not.
Foul on Bielak. And Bradburn Lewis will go to the line for two.
Bradburn Lewis, very active both ends of the floor, and he's really put in a shift this second quarter. Some points on the board. Been a catalyst for some of these runs that his teams are on.
Oh, a couple of steals, 4 points, make that five now. Good use of the 8 minutes he's played so far. 10-point lead to the little brother.
Well, we all said it, you know, the little brother can get you on any day. Just know he's got bragging rights now.
You're stepping his way through.
It's
Good defense. Very loading good. The shot clock. Oh, that's a tough shot from Jimenez.
Jimenez, really, really good control there off the spin. Big shot for him and his team there.
Two to go here in the first half. In the Lynch Trophy. First game for these two in this competition. Majura is going to take that from behind the arc, off the back of the iron, and the long rebound comes out to Bielak. Dietrich steps into the three, finally they get one to go. And Jonas Dietrich is the only guy who's hit from behind the arc for Loughborough in this first half. He's made three of them. The rest of his team have really struggled, but it's cut the lead down to six, and you feel like this is an important 91 seconds left here in this first half, because if Loughborough can win this last 90 seconds by a basket or two and go in, you know, just down two or three points, they'll feel they've got away with one there, having been down double figures.
Yeah, logically as well, you know, I'm sure the coach will tell them that you're shooting 12% from the three-point line or there or thereabouts, and then, you know, they'll look to change that fortune in the second half. So the law of averages, you would expect them to shoot better. But Jimenez there, fantastic awareness there. This that you just said, Jonas Dietrich, the only one to make a three. He's pushed the basketball and created space for his teammate with an easy layout. And you know, when you're stepping into a shot like that, any pro, that's the, you know, it's almost guaranteed buckets there. And you know, Dietrich just there, great follow through there. No, this will be the first area of adversity that this Charnwood College team has seen in the second quarter anyway, because they pretty much had the, you know, the fair share of the control in this quarter, the runs, the energy, the offensive production. So it'll be interesting to see how they're able to weather the storm here as they approach the halftime.
Well, they're winning this quarter 24 points to 14.
Wow.
So far, which translates to a 6-point advantage in the game.
24 points in one quarter as well. It's impressive in any level of standard.
Well, they have led by as many as 11. It's down to 6. Duca drops it off. Majura can't convert, and Duca though will get them a new 14. Looking to attack again. Nice pass inside. He just kind of lost his footing, and then in the end gets the shot blocked by Mutipo.
That's great work from Nduku though.
Dietrich again, same spot, different result this time. Wild with the rebound in the final minute. And that's going to be a transition foul.
Bad foul too, number five.
It'll be two free throws. It's also, well, Jimenez's second personal foul.
I'm almost 100 miles, well, a couple hundred miles away from him as Leicester Riders are away today, but I have flashbacks of Rob Patnash just screaming.
Yeah.
Just screaming. This is one of the worst errors you could commit was fouling over here in the team, in one of the teams in the bonus.
Well, he might be watching the stream at this time. You never know. Screaming at his laptop. Dietrich, nice pass inside. Oh, blown layup though. Should have been an easy 2 points from Tifa, but somehow he comes up with nothing. Robin Lewis tosses it cross court. Once or twice today, he's just thrown that pass blind in the hope that somebody would be there. And that one a little too wild. They can almost run this down to the buzzer. Not going to though, it's going all the way in, lays it in. Gives a few seconds left to Charnwood here. Down to 5, needs to go up. Long range 3 is off the mark. And that will do it. Very good first quarter here at Loughborough University and it is Charnwood College, the underdog coming in, who lead at the half by 38 points to 33.
Oh, that's what you want. Well, that's what I wanted to see as a spectator and calling this game. I wanted to see a hard-fought game from both teams, and that's exactly what we're seeing. Some shots aren't dropping for reasons we've already explained, but you know, you have to give credit to Charnwood College, who's coming to today's game, as you said, the underdogs. But you know, they don't care. They're not playing by the script, and it's made for a very entertaining game. And I'm already excited for the second half.
Well, we're going to take a little pause. We'll be back with you on the other side of halftime. Well, welcome back, if you went away, to Loughborough University, where we are in Lynch Trophy action. It's Group 3. It's the first game for Charnwood and Loughborough Riders going head-to-head, and it is the young boys of Charnwood College who lead by 5 at the half. And Ant Rowe, I mean, I know if you spoke to Will Maynard before the game and said you were up 5 at half, he would have snapped your hand off, but there'd be part of him thinking, ooh, it could have been a few more.
Yeah, for sure, and credit to Coach Maynard as well. You know, his team looks organised, they're looking at good, you know, positive mental state as well in terms of their chances here as well. So you're right, he's walked into there at halftime, you know, I think instilling even more belief in his team that they can get a scalp here.
And from a Loughborough perspective, you would imagine that they would be in no uncertain circumstances that they need to improve in the second half if they're going to win this game.
Too many turnovers, you know. Coach Sharon will definitely be hammering onto that, and also just not make shots, you know, just not setting the feet possibly, or not following through. But whatever the reason, you know, Jonas Dietrich was the only one really who could consistently hit that three.
3 of 18 they were in the first half from the 3-point line. 4 of 11 from the free throw line. So I mean, there's 15, 18 points, you would say, from that shooting that you would expect to be on the board that isn't. You know, I'll have to be better in this half. It's gamble from the free throw line to get the scoring underway and cut the gap to 3.
And that's what Loughborough does have. You know, if they're not shooting the ball well from the 3-point shot, they've got veteran, good professional players on their squad that they can find other methods of scoring the ball.
Majuro with the offensive rebound to keep it alive. He's now looking to go to work in the paint. Well, somehow managed to get that one to go. He's under all sorts of pressure.
Majuro definitely thoroughly deserved that shot too.
Gamble with the 3-point shot. That one doesn't drop either. Gamble over 4 now from behind the arc. Greg Wild certainly isn't, although that one is off the mark. Duke driving hard in the basket. He was very aggressive in the first half as well.
He's very good at catching that basketball in motion at the top of the 3-point line. He finds a way to get inside of those danger areas of the defense.
Nice pass from Gamble underneath to Headley, who will go to the line for a bonus as he takes the contact and the chance to make a 3-point play.
Fantastic vision there from Harrison Gamble. It's very easy sometimes as well when you're that, you know, player that the team's going to look to put points on the board and start forcing shots up, but he's done a fantastic, disciplined job there in finding the open man.
Well, easily the most experienced player. They'll take that one again. Harrison Gamble on either roster. 10 BBL trophies to his name. Second is good for Headley. The second attempt of the 3-point play. Tipped out of bounds by Dietrich.
Well, Headley will be graciously. He got a redo.
Yeah. And it's Wild. From 18 feet off the mark, and Majuru with the offensive rebound. Duke wanted it down low, but they go back up top. Shot clock down to 5 here. Wild penetrating, kicks out, needs to go up. Does go up. Another offensive rebound, third chance opportunity for Charnwood. Still can't get it to go. Another one. They have been aggressive on the glass. Again, the shot clock being counted down by the Charnwood bench. And if you give a team enough goes at it, we're going to score eventually.
Goodso as well. He's definitely not shy with that fast dribble pull-up shot. Nice hit from him there.
Almost loses it. And somehow they get Dietrich underneath. And that was a very lucky bouncing ball for Loughborough.
Fine line between turning the ball over and scoring. And that occasion, it was example there on the Loughborough offense.
Well, Coach Shannon was shouting at his man. I think even though they got the points, he wasn't too happy. It's a tough shot there from Majuru. an offensive foul. It's a good stand. The only question was where his feet were. They must have been outside the circle. Second personal foul on Headley. John, we're still leading by four here, 2.5 into the second half.
You've noticed an increased intensity from the Loughborough University basketball outfit, though. Charnwood College.
Turning it over wild. It's kicked out front. Gambles ahead of Dietrich. If he can get it to him, he can. They recovered well, but they didn't find Dietrich. Again, we just had the numbers there. Loughborough and Headley will go to the line looking to try and become the second man on his team in double figures.
Well, you've seen the experience now, this Loughborough basketball team. Balls have been in the hands quite a lot already this quarter, and Gamble and Dietrich and Headley just been very active. He's on the line again and he's been finding himself ways to score the basketball.
They're going to do it again. He's got another do-over. Lane violation, not something you see very often. We've seen it twice in the first 3 minutes here. And he doesn't make amends this time. Oh, that, ooh, a lucky one there. Hayden just couldn't quite corral the ball. Is wild, working the high pick and roll, kick to the corner. And that was one where Jordan was thinking about what he was going to do with the ball before he had it. And they've been chipping away, Loughborough. And they can potentially tie it on this play. Headley getting into the lane is fouled. And Majuru not convinced, but... Well, we were talking about saying Harrison Gamble was the most experienced man on the court. Probably revised that because referee Roger Harrison is far and away the most experienced man on the basketball court.
It's a true story. He's been operating in these circles for a long, long time.
Made the call there. And once again, Hadley at the... Headley even at the free throw line goes 1-for-2.
Well, even Headley, one of the more experienced players here, 24 years old, played professionally over in Germany. He's got that British German dual passport, so you know he's been around the around the block with his counterparts, Dietrich and Gamble.
Played Pro B as well last year in Germany. That's off the mark, and here come Loughborough. Definitely started the better here in the second half, and a chance to tie the game up. And that pass is deflected away. And I think it'll be interesting, having spent so much of the first half in front, what would happen if they go behind? Well, they're level now. Loughborough wheeled it all back in, having been down by 11, tied the game at 44. Oh, it's a top finish from Nduku there.
Nduku showing some individual talent, but you still got concerns around that Charnwood College offense. Haven't really got anything consistently efficient around the rim, but Nduku, just talented individual.
Offensive rebound. Both teams have been crashing the glass here today. Gamble cutting through. Nice feed. And Harrison Gamble jumps it in. It was a lovely bounce pass from Headley to find him.
Fantastic play there. And Harrison Gamble cut at the perfect time. Headley repaying the favour.
Wild for another three. Three in the first half. There's his first to the second.
Greg Wild is not ready for Loughborough to take this lead.
He leads all scorers with 17 now, 4 of 7 from behind the arc. Bradburn Lewis checks into the game. It's a tough pass to find Gamble in the corner. Here's Gamble popping out for three, left it a little bit short. Offensive rebound from Jimenez. Here's Dudley again looking to go to work. That's a pretty easy call for the official. Brandon Lewis getting full value out of his foul.
What you can say about Hedley is he knows how to get to the free throw line.
Well, the bulk score has him down as 3 of 5 from the free throw line today.
Ooh.
It was actually 3 of 7 because he got 2 retakes. Not that it counts, but...
Maybe that's messing with my perception, because I feel like he's been there a lot today.
He has in the second half. It's all been in the second half. But he's been taking the contact. And he goes 2 for 2 this time. 1-point lead. A little full court pressure here for Charnwood to deal with, and they don't deal with it. Dietrich with the steal. Jimenez out in front. Zips it to Gamble on the trail, and the finger roll from Harrison Gamble puts the Loughborough Riders in front.
Great play there. Jimenez done a lot of that, made really good decisions today, and that was another one. Harrison Gamble extends those long 6'10" arms for the finish.
So Charnwood behind for the first time since the opening quarter. How do they react to that? We're definitely with all the momentum. Dietrich trying to add to it. Offensive rebound in there. And that's been one of the things here in this second half that Loughborough have done really well on the offensive glass. They've got 11 rebounds in total at the offensive end. But many of them coming here in the first 6 minutes of this third quarter.
Their intensity's just increased as well. You can noticeably difference from the first half. The defensive sets as well, that full court pressure's been implemented by Coach Jeremy, making things very difficult for the Charnwood team to make those cross-court passes as well, hand in the passing lanes.
Well, having converted from the free throw line, Hayden will be replaced by Mutifo. Again, Loughborough coming with this 2-2-1 press. Well, that's a brave shot in that situation. Able to turn it into another offense, and Greg Wild doesn't need much space. Greg Wild knocks down his 5th triple of the game.
Wow. Absolutely no conscience out there. Let's it go. And
Gamble driving in, takes the foul, and Loughborough have been living on the free throw line here in the third quarter. This time it'll be Gamble shooting 2.
Well, it's clearly been the message from Mark Jeremy. He's seen the three-point percentage, and perhaps it's not your day, so he's instilled the mentality of get to the rim, make things happen. And his team have responded, as you said, you know, Gamble, Hedley, they found ways to get to the rim and get the charm with defense to commit fouls.
Here's Wild again. That was a long 2 this time. But he has really filled it up in this ball game. 22 points of his team's 54. shot call there. He would have turned that over. That was a really unnecessary foul. And with the fouls going against them in this third quarter, that means two more free throws. You can see the reaction from Coach Maynard, less than impressed. You were talking about Rob Paternostro. That was one out of the Rob Paternostro playbook there.
Well, Will's been on the other side of those many a time, so I guess it's natural that he relays on what he's learned. But, you know, you gotta feel, I feel, you know, sorry for Brad Burn Lewis there, because he's been someone who's been very successful in the steals in this game. He's anticipated passes and has been rewarded for that. But on that occasion, I'm a foul and not a breakaway bucket. Ooh.
Well, that was the right pass. It was probably just about half a second too late there. Gusha didn't quite see it on the first viewing, because all on his own underneath was Perry, who would have scored if he'd given him the ball at the right time. Nice pass, almost blocked, went straight through the block. Perry got a big chunk of that, but Ntipo was able to score anyway.
Well, Ntipo, fantastic finish there, and I'm sure that miss in the first half is still on his mind, so he was 100% certain he was converting that. Great play from him.
While just not getting the ball down in time there, as he saw the lane to the basket, called for the travelling violation. Loughborough Riders 56, Charnwood Riders 54, and Gamble's just having a look going, what was that?
Well, that was an odd pass there from Headley, and Gamble almost lost it, almost left it, thinking there was a person behind him.
I think he was coming up for the screen, so he just wasn't expecting the pass to be anywhere near him. Ben Lewis able to recover that. Penetrates in, but bounces it off his own foot, and it will be a Loughborough ball. Well, they've weathered the storm okay here, actually. They're losing this quarter 23-16, but they've weathered the initial storm, I think, Charnwood, and they're still in the game, only down two. Here's Gamble, steps back behind the arc, does he? No, it doesn't matter as the shot doesn't go in. Here's Brabourne Lewis in transition. Nice little penetration into the lane. But Guzza left that one a little bit short. He took the right option there.
He wanted to pass that to the corner, but wasn't there.
Nice work on the pick and roll, and here is Guzza in the corner, but he misses everything. Shot clock doesn't reset, it's turned over anyway. And Loughborough have looked much more effective in transition in the second half. Nice Dietrich on the end of that one. Here's Greg Wild missing. I'm just wondering whether Coach Maynard might call a timeout here. It's late in the quarter, you don't like to burn them at this stage. But his team might go down to their biggest deficit of the game here. Oh, unable to finish inside there in Ntipo.
It's a good move from Ntipo, yeah, too. Right. He won that back.
Tough from Bradley Lewis. Almost got that one to go. They will shoot two. Well, they haven't been to the free throw line in this half. It's been a bit of a procession at the other end, but a chance here to get some points without the clock ticking. First one is off the mark. He's had an eventful game. Bradburn Lewis, 6 points, a couple of steals, a couple of rebounds, 3 turnovers. He's been all action out there.
Yeah, he's been very active. Had a positive influence on his team's performance.
inside the final minute of the third quarter. Loughborough trail by as many as 11, lead by three here. Pass deflected, but Loughborough still have it. Gamble fakes the three, resets himself, rims out. That'll be one thing they'll be working on before Tuesday, the three-point shooting, although Wilde doesn't need to, because Greg Wilde has been unconscious today from behind the arc. He knocks down yet another three. It's his sixth of the game. Dietrich can't reply with, oh, he's about to say tied at 58 with a chance for Charnwood to take the lead on the final play, but somehow they cough it up. And it will be Loughborough who get the ball with 1.1 second differential between the shot and the game clock here. 14 on the shot clock, 15.1 on the game clock. Munoz has a glance back at the clock, sees it at 7 now. Counted down by his teammates. Gamble inside. It's a good cut. And he had the much smaller Greg Wilde behind him. All Wilde could do is foul. It's not the worst foul, except for the fact that it's his fourth. So it's one of them that you would normally say is a decent foul, make him earn them from the line, but Wilde has been so influential offensively with 25 points, they can't really lose him. Coach Maynard's going to take him out for a bit. Oh, no, he's not. I assume.
Well, they're on offense, aren't they? Yeah, so you'd want to utilize a three-point shot if Greg wants to, Greg Wilde wants to put one down now.
Well, they've done really well to get that length of the floor. Here's Jordan, he had to go up first time. Did he get up in time? Referees look at each other, basket will count. Well, they put him on for the last 2 seconds, and he delivers on the buzzer, and Charnwood have tied it up here, and we are level going into the fourth quarter. I don't think too many people watching at home would have expected this with 10 minutes to go. It's 60 apiece.
Not at all, and I have to show an appreciation for that play, that last play. It was like they inbounded it from the half court because the ball wasn't touched by the offensive club until the centerpiece there. So it was a very, very well an executed play there, and Jordan with a soft finish.
It was good from Guto, fake towards the ball and then came away, which allowed the pass over the top. And as you say, they got halfway down the court before the clock started ticking because he hadn't touched it. And then I did think for a second, when he didn't take the shot, Jordan, he's going to run out of time, but he was adjudged to have got it out of his hand just in time by the officials. So we are level at 60. And I suppose if you're Charnwood, you're going into this fourth quarter and saying, look, they just scored 27 against us in that third quarter, and we are still level in this ball game, and we've just got to win 10 minutes and we win this game.
Well, offensively, they did a good job to hang around, because for me, when I looked at their second quarter performance and third quarter performance, it felt like quite a discrepancy there, and I didn't feel like they freely scored 22 points on the board there. But what they did is they just found a way to get it done. They chipped away here and there, and I think what's most impressive from this Charnwood College team is the mentality. It's very, very easy to get down on yourself. You know, when that team who is posted to win this game before tip off, come and have a big run at that, and that's what Loughborough did. You could just tell the intensity shifted up, maybe from gear four to gear five, and you could just tell in everything they did, their intent offensively and defensively was with a lot more intensity and intent. But Charnwood College has been able to embrace that, and here we are, 60-60, and very good basketball game.
Well, the concern will be for Charnwood here with 10 minutes to go that their captain with 25 points and 7 rebounds is on 4 fouls, and Greg Wilde will start this fourth quarter on the bench, and I'm assuming that Coach Maynard will want to leave him there for as long as the scoreboard allows him to and bring him in for the final stretch. And the question is, when the guy that's got over a third of your offense is on the bench, who else can score? Bradford Lewis driving through. Probably could have tossed that one up when he heard the whistle, but he was through the pass, so it'll be an end line ball. Ooh. Jordan fires up for three, left that one short. Guter was able to chase it down. Again, the shot clock getting low. Kick back to Bradburn Lewis at the top for three. And another offensive rebound. Jordan this time pulling it in.
Thought Jordan was going to let it go.
And after they did it at the start of the second half, they cracked the offensive boards. And they ended up with a score, and they've done it once again here to regain the lead at the start of the fourth.
You give any good basketball team that many chances and they will punish you, and that's exactly what Hansen did there from the corner.
And the volume from the Charnwood players has really gone up behind their teammates as Dietrich can't tie the game up, gets his own rebound though, and he will shoot two, having been fouled from behind by Goodson. Number two on him. And Loughborough really haven't shot the free throws very well today. Have got to the line a lot in the second half. They have been a little bit better in this second half, but still down in the 50s percentage-wise. Both of those are good. 1 point game. Again, they come with this little press from Lewis for the one-footed fall away. Dietrich looking to back down. Use the strength, good help from Robin Lewis to knock it loose, but Loughborough still have it. Stumbling through the lane, the shot off the back of the ring from Bielak. Goodser in transition to the hole, with a finger roll. And Charnwood are 8 minutes away from an upset here in the Lynch Trophy.
Goodser's change of pace is electrifying. He's able to get down the court in incredibly quick speed. And here he is again.
With the steal, and that's going to be a foul. Is it unsportsmanlike? It is indeed an unsportsmanlike foul. So Charnwood are going to get two in possession here with 7:58 on the clock. And a three-point lead.
That's all it takes, Dan. That swing of momentum, that even the bench, you know, you can feel the energy just swing. But Goodser, active hands, quick feet. Absolute nuisance in the passing lanes.
First one. Doesn't drop. He makes a second though. Possession in the front court, so 14 seconds on the shot clock. Oh, nice inbound. Goodser kicks it out to the corner for three off the back of the iron. And Loughborough have a chance to break here. Headley trying to. It turns it over. Goodser again with the steal. Goes it alone and finishes under pressure. What a footer he's having.
Goodser, excellent job to use his body as well to shield off that defender. He had options either way, but he took it himself.
Jimenez knew that was it. He was halfway down court before the ball rattled home. And that was three much-needed points for Loughborough.
Jimenez has done very little wrong today. I feel like he's had a very solid game. Look for him to make some big plays in this fourth quarter.
Jordan to reply with three of his own. Another offensive rebound for Charnwood. Robert Lewis fires it up. Jimenez, right place, right time. The rebound falls right to him. Here he is. Is he going to step into another? No, he attacks. Kicked out to the corner. Gamble to tie it. Jordan fighting hard for that rebound.
Good rebound. Very good rebound for the youngster.
Oh, Bradley Lewis just lost the handle there. Nice no-look pass. Dietrich at the way and tipped in by Gamble. And Coach Maynard wants to talk it over. His team still lead, but only 5-1 here with 6:35 to go. But they will feel they have a really good shot. And from Loughborough's point of view, at some point, with it being so close, is do they get a bit tight because they're going, we can't lose to the youngest.
Well, I don't know, but what I will say is that when a team turns the ball over, the other team punish them, and you know that's essentially what's happening there. Unfortunately, Bradford Lewis was on the receiving end of that turnover, but again, Loughborough out on a shot, looking to punish them. Wow, what a game.
Well, to your point, 35 points from turnovers between the two teams, and there have been 31 turnovers in the game, and anytime you get above 1 point per turnover, you're in good territory. So both teams doing a good job on that, and well, this one could very much go either way with 6:35 to go. What a start to the Lynch Trophy for these two teams. In a group with the Nottingham Hoods and the Leicester Warriors. Loughborough play Nottingham on Tuesday. Charnwood would play next Sunday, also against Nottingham. And then the Warriors are here next a week on Tuesday, the 10th. And Charnwood would finish out on the 15th of November, all things being equal, against the Warriors at Charnwood. Guza lobbing it inside, nice pass. Njuru, he didn't quite ever look comfortable in that, and he ends up losing possession. And again, Loughborough can regain the lead. Jimenez. Defoe almost stolen away by driving in, foul pulled.
Tifo's done really well there. He's got hands down low, and Guza being a nuisance and almost coming up with a steal there.
Nduku back into the game.
Good sign for Charnwood. He's someone who's not shied away from making things happen on the offensive end, and you know, big body, active on the defensive end as well.
And Tifo ties the game at 68. Can he put his team in front with 6 minutes to play? No. And Majura with the rebound. Charnwood looking to edge back ahead. It's a lot going through his hands here in the fourth quarter. Good strong work, you just talk about him. Nduku straight off the bench, instant impact.
Really like his offensive game.
Lovely shot, he's blocked by Amajuru. Nduku kicks it out. Well, that was probably a little earlier in the offense than they needed, Charnwood. And Gamble did well to keep that in bounds. Here he is again, stepping into three. Harrison turns what could have been a turnover into string music for three.
Just like that, a player of his caliber can give you an instant 3-point shot. Up by one, Loughborough University.
Well, Harrison Gamble had been 0 of 8 from the 3-point line, but he absolutely stringed that one to give his team a 1-point lead. And they get a stop to follow it up. Dietrich streaking to the basket, and he lays it in. And in the blink of the eye, it's a 3-point Loughborough lead.
Dietrich is so good at that. He's got a really quick endurance kind of body. He was always, you know, he would run all day, and very smart outlet there.
Craig Wilde getting ready to check back into the game for Charnwood. Duku under all sorts of pressure, rings out on the shot, and Tifo with the rebound. Jimenez kicks it out. Dietrich in the corner for three! And suddenly everything going in for Loughborough. What a minute that has been. Gamble for three. Dietrich in transition. Then again from the corner for three. And 8 points in the blink of an eye have given Loughborough a 6-point lead, all while Greg Wilde was getting ready to come back into the game. And suddenly it's a big deficit for Charnwood to deal with here with 4 minutes and 10 seconds to play.
Wow, you can just see that experience, can't you? You know that a lot of those players have been in this situation before, and you look at the Charnwood offense as well there. A lot of isolation plays, a lot of one-on-one, but the Loughborough basketball outfit maintained and stayed true to their team offense there, and have got good looks as a result. Jonas Dietrich, big. Harrison Gamble, big plays. That experience is oozing into this game.
Well, they spent most of the game behind, but they now, with 4 minutes and 10 seconds to play, have their biggest advantage of the contest. At 6 points, they led by five in the first half. But now they have a 6-point cushion, and you feel like Charm would need a score coming out of this timeout.
Sorry,
I just need to do the hand sanitization. I assume this will become second nature to them. There's been a few times where they've needed reminding the players in today's game.
Yeah, I always wonder how that feels as well, on the ball shooting the ball. And
well, obviously the ball gets sanitized as well during the course of the game. It's my go-to excuse now for a missed shot. Slippy ball.
Of course.
Big shot here, Bradford Lewis for three, but off the mark. Loughborough looking to land the killer blow here. No way through, but an offensive rebound from Tifo, and they get a new 14. Jimenez spies a gap, kicks out to Gamble, corner three. Well, they haven't hit the threes all game, but suddenly, in the last minute and a half, Loughborough have hit three threes, and they've opened out a 9-point lead.
What a find as well in the corner from Harrison Gamble.
Wild shot doesn't go, and you get the feeling that Charnwood might have run their race here. They had 35 very good minutes, Charnwood. But the game is played for 40, and Loughborough, who've not been at their best, have seemingly pulled it out at the end here. It's going to be two more free throws. And with 3 minutes just under to play, Loughborough can take a double-figure lead.
Kyle Jimenez. Solid game from him today. Again, coming up with the goods when his team's trying to put this game away. But I think you hit the nail on the head, Dan. I think we were coming to that 5-minute period remaining in the fourth quarter. Charnwood got a little bit tighter and Loughborough stepped up to the plate. And that could be the difference, you know. If you're going to take a lead, take it in the
You only need to lead once at the end. And they've got their biggest lead of the game. First time they've been into double figures. It's 11 for him. And he's got 11.7 assists and 6 rebounds. He's wild. He's had an excellent game himself, particularly from this distance. And he's knocked down his 7th three-pointer of the game. He's 7 for 11 for 28 points.
What a show he's put on. Incredible. Doesn't need a lot of space to get that shot off. He's not the biggest player out there by any means. He's probably the smallest player, but boy, does he let that shot go fast.
Jordan in a bit of trouble, gets out of it. Bradford Lewis in the corner. Oh, what a shot! Right over Harrison Gamble diving out. The lights would have been going out when you see big 6'10 Harrison gambled last night, but he was able to knock you down. And that's Greg Wild's game done. Came over the back. He was on four fouls, and that was always the gamble. But what a tremendous ball game this young man has had. 28.7 rebounds, but most impressively of all, 7 for 11 from three-point range for 63%.
Yeah, he hasn't forced the issue, is he? He's been aggressive, but he hasn't overshot the ball.
Harrison Gamble missed his first 8 three-point attempts. He's made the last three.
Just like that, he can turn it on. It's that professional caliber he's played in some big, big games. And I think the mental toughness to stay locked into a game as well, when perhaps it hasn't went your way for, you know, X amount of shots before, as you said, eight shots before.
Well, they've just, the three that he's made have been so smooth as well. They look like a guy who'd made eight before, never mind missing eight before. Man. Just a damp patch on the floor. Needs sorting out. And Dooku sits down. He may well have run his race for the day as well. 12 points and 7 rebounds. Definitely made an impact for his team positively.
Very good game from that young man. You got to think as well, players against his own age, you know, he could do some serious damage.
Unless they're just running it out here. They've had a good test. Here's Gamble again. Oh, he's a dungeon here in the fourth quarter. Harrison Gamble.
The demoralizing thing is you got to remember Harrison Gamble's 6'10", so even if you're jumping as high as you can.
Oh no! Oh, the foul as well! The beautiful assist behind the back.
Wow!
Juru will get in line for a 3-point play.
Beautiful play. A staple finish to complement that silky behind the back pass. Wow, we've got some highlights today,
well,
Dan.
Yeah, that's the one to clip up for social media, isn't it? And he converts the 3-point play. And a press up court trying to force the issue here with just over a minute to go, down 10. Gambling on everything. Loughborough just running the clock down here. Needs to go off. Headley. It's going to be a shot clock violation if it isn't a Charnwood ball. It is a 24-second violation. Well, Coach Maynard is still feeling there's something in it for his team here, trailing by 10. With 49 seconds to go.
That defensive effort from Charnwood was really executed well, because you've got Harrison Gamble at the top there setting the pick. And he's not rolling, he's popping there to that corner, and they did a really good job of switching on that and preventing Headley from getting that ball to Gamble, who probably would have caught that and hit another three. Yeah. So they've been able to adjust, which is encouraging to see. But unfortunately for them, it's 49.4 seconds left, and they're going to have to get some quick scores now to be in contention of getting back into this ball game.
Well, Gamble, with an index rating of 30, leads his team 26 points, 11 rebounds, and 4 assists on a night where for 35 minutes he didn't really shoot the ball very well. But that is what he can do at any given moment. And you did get a sense when that first one went in, it was going to be the first of many, and he has been 4-4 from three-point range when the game is on the line. Well, let's see what Will Maynard is drawing up here for Charnwood. They'll want to go quickly. Three, really what they need, but whatever it is, it needs to be quick. It's Jordan in the corner, but Gamble was wise to it and closed it out. Zuku driving in hard. Gamble fighting for the rebound. Dietrich comes away with it. And Coach Maynard screaming for a foul. And I don't think he did Lily Jordan any favours there, because when the coach is screaming for a foul and you run over like that, the referee is thinking, well, is he making a play for the ball? It's an unsportsmanlike foul. And that was not the outcome that Coach Maynard wanted.
I really, really detest that rule. It's I think if it's extraordinary circumstances where there's malicious intent, but that is that really does bother me, that call.
Well, Gamble adding to his tally, although missing the second from the free throw line. And it's whether they bother fouling again now or just let it run out. They are going to foul. You see, was that any less deliberate than the last one?
That's the question, Dan. That is the question.
I still think Will screaming foul, foul, foul did not help Louis Jordan at all there.
We've all been there as players too. Deer in the headlights, someone screwed up your line.
Well, Jimenez at the free throw line, that's 12 points for him, 9 assists and 6 rebounds.
I think he's been brilliant today. He's made some really good decisions in big pivotal parts of the game. I like his composure under pressure as well.
Loved into Majuru, crowded out of it. Duke is backing down, using his strength, and a little fall away with the soft touch. Will it drop? Yes, it will.
He is tough. Really finesse with the dribble. Good control, but power. Soft touch.
And Loughborough will run it out here. And, if you only see the final score on social media or on the website later, you'll think, 92-81. But what a ball game that was. And for 35 minutes, Charnwood were very much in with a shot of pulling off what would have been a significant upset here in the Lynch Trophy. But the last 5 minutes is when Loughborough came with their class, with Gamble knocking down three-pointers, with Dietrich adding in 5 important points, and you talked about Jimenez as well and Headley. They just had that extra something in the last 5 minutes to win this ball game.
They did. It was, both well-coached, well-drilled teams. You know, the intensity from start to finish was there for both teams, regardless of whether they're making shots or not. But what a game of basketball. You know, we saw some really, really good displays. You know, got to be a shout out to Greg Wald as well. He was absolutely unconscious from that 3-point line and didn't force the issue as well. He was just very efficient with it. And unfortunately for him, his day had to end a little bit earlier. But no, Dan, you hit the nail on the head. The experience of the Loughborough outfit, you know, your Harrison Gambles, your Jonas Dietrich, just stepping up big in the last stages of the fourth quarter was just that little bit over. But look, I think at the end of the day, the Leicester Riders, Loughborough University, and Charnwood College basketball programs can be very, very happy with the performance they've seen. There's some very, very exciting talent out on court today.
It certainly was a very entertaining game in the Lynch Trophy for Loughborough. They move on to Tuesday, where they will take on the Nottingham Hoods here at Loughborough University. And for Charnwood, their next action is against Nottingham as well. That's next Sunday. But it's been a long time in coming getting these two teams underway in the Lynch Trophy. But boy, did they put on a show for us. For Amp Row, I'm Daniel Routledge. Thank you very much for joining us, and we'll see you again very soon.